I used to edit my videos on my MacBook Pro, I think for 2 or 3 years, and, well, let me just show you. You see that here? The A and the S, they're all gone. And that shows you how important these DaVinci Resolve shortcuts are. I hit these keys hundreds of times every day, and I want you to start using them too, because it will drastically speed up your editing. And I'm actually gonna show you 4 simple shortcuts, but they work really well together. It's a super powerful combination. Now, if you aren't using these shortcuts yet, then once you start using them in the beginning, it might feel a bit stiff and rough, like it's not helping at all, but that's just because your muscle memory has to get used to it. It has to adjust. Just use them for a few weeks and really force yourself to use them, and you'll see that eventually your editing will go a lot faster. And the key, pun intended, the key to using shortcuts efficiently is making sure that your most used shortcuts are reachable by one hand. So for me, that's my left hand for the shortcuts and my right hand is on my mouse. Okay, let's start with the first shortcut. It's split clip. Now, what does it do? It splits a clip. I have split clip mapped as D. Why? I don't know. You can map it as whatever you want. And how do you do that? Well, first go to the menu up here and then select keyboard customization. Make sure you select all commands here and then type in split there. And then just select the box and type in whatever key you want to use. It's that simple. Save and done. And now whenever I hit D, it will split the clip under the playhead. The next shortcut is ripple start to playhead and ripple end to playhead. By default, these commands are mapped as command plus shift plus left or right bracket on Mac. On Windows, it's probably control plus shift plus left or right bracket. And what these shortcuts do is, well, ripple start will take the start of your clip, trim it to the playhead, and then move everything behind the playhead, so on the right, to the left. So all of that with just one keystroke, like this. Boom. And ripple end will of course do the same, but with the end of the clip. I have these two mapped as A and S, so close to the split clip shortcut, D. And then finally, delete selected. By default, this is backspace. I have it mapped as W. So select a clip and hit W, and it's gone. And here's an extra shortcut that's super useful, ripple delete. Ripple delete will delete the selected clip and then move everything on the right, so behind that clip, to the left. I have ripple delete mapped as shift W. And that's it. The combination of those shortcuts is so powerful, you really have to start using them. So one hand for the shortcuts, one hand on your mouse, and you'll be flying, man, really. Just give it a few weeks for your muscle memory to adjust and to get used to these shortcuts. And that's it. Thank you so much for watching and see you in the next one.